single camera productions can be used to produce a program films, soap operas, and also it can be used to produce segments of a multi-camera production. If you see the definition of single camera production is nothing but we are using a single camera to record an event or to record a news program. If you see the ENG, electronic news gathering, it is a technique generally used by the television channels. Generally, a camera person along with the television news reporter is going to the location where the event is happening. If they want to shoot an accident, please, etc., that they are deployed there and that is going to be captured for the audience. If it is a live, generally a DSNG van or OB van is used for the live transmission of the program. Otherwise, if it is a single camera production, the recording takes place at one point of time, and after that, after shooting, you are arranging all the shots in a sequence and that is being edited for the audience and then it is being transmitted for the audience. So single camera productions can be live and it can also be offline programs where you record at one point of time, edit one point of time and it can be transmitted after that. If you see the advantages of single camera production, single camera productions can be managed by a single person or it can be managed by two different persons. For example, if you take ENG kind of production, generally one camera person, one television news reporter is going to the spot to cover a beat. For covering this beat, generally based on the instructions of the television news reporter, the camera person is composing the shot. And after that, that is being recorded in a memory card, maybe it is being recorded in a tape. That can be directly edited by the television news reporter and it can also be edited by the persons who are in the concerned television channel. So depending on the kind of program you are making for the audience, what kind of equipment you have for the transmission of the program. If it is an offline program, generally, there is no need for light. For example, if it is a public meeting, the entire program can be recorded. If it is a multi-camera production, or the entire thing can be recorded using a single camera. But whether you are going on live or whether it is going to be transmitted in between in a news bulletin, depending on that, they choose as an offline program or online program. If it is a news magazine, television reporter using a single camera, he records the event, then that has been again sent it to the concerned television channel. After that, the editing takes place. Sometimes the television reporter himself edits the story, writes the script, and that is sent to the concerned television channel. And sometimes the television reporter may not edit the story and the original tape, whatever is there, that is going to be sent for the concerned television channel where the editing takes place. The visuals are incorporated along with the bites of the persons who are present on the location. Along with that, the voiceover is added and that is all that is mixed like a package and that is being transmitted for the audience. So news magazine also can be a part of your single camera production. So as I said, multi-camera productions where we are using multiple cameras, but if it is a single camera production recording for a television serial, generally if you are using single camera may be placed before the talent record the shot, then they move the camera physically to the other end or they move to other place, then that is also being shot. Then when you want to shoot the close-up, for example, if a conversation between two persons in a soap opera, generally first can be a wide shot which will be shot, the two persons will be there on the screen. Then we can move to showing the one subject in that conversation, and when you want to show the reaction of the other person when a dialogue is delivered by the first person, then you have to physically move the camera and the same dialogue is said again and that has been again recorded for taking the reaction of the other person. So in that way, physically, when you are moving the camera from one place to another place and you are recording the same shot. Finally, when you are editing using this single camera production, generally during the editing stage, all these shots are mixed and a sequence or a scene is made out of it. So if you see the electronic news gathering, generally a single camera is used for the purpose of news gathering. If it is live, as I said, that the same way SNG van or maybe OB van can be used to transmit in live. Otherwise, the program can be edited later and it can be transmitted for the audience later time. If you see ENG and EFE, ENG is nothing but electronic news gathering and EFE is electronic field production. So ENG and EFP are both are outdoor productions or field productions. There is only a little bit of difference is there. If you see EFP, a single camera production is ENG. If it is a multi-camera production, generally, you can use EFP, electronic field production. For example, if you want to shoot a cricket match or any other sports, etc., then you are using electronic field production. In that also you are using multiple camera setup. A production control room can be like OB van if you are going for live from the location. So if it is live, generally electronic news gathering, or if it is a EFP, whatever may be, if it is going to be live, generally SNG van technology or OB van we can use for the live transmission. If you see the advantages of electronic field production, the program is taking place in a real location. You are actually going to the spot and recording the event, even though it is ENG or EFP, whatever. You are going to the place where the action or event is taking place and that you are recording for the audience. If a set may not provide that kind of actuality, whatever in the film. If you compare with the multi-camera production, EFP or ENG can be a low budget productions. ENG, electronic news gathering, a television reporter may, along with the camera person, may go and record the visuals for the news program. Or a producer or the director using a single camera may produce a film. EFP or ENG cut down the rent of the studio floor. So if it is a multi-camera production taking place in a studio, generally on day-to-day basis, you have to pay for the concerned studio. But if it is ENG, there is no need for paying the fees. If it is an electronic field production, generally you have to take permission from the persons where you are shooting. For example, if you want to shoot in front of Arts College, if you want to use a drone camera, etc., you have to get permission from the principal, you have to get permission, or you have to get permission from the registrar. Also, you have to inform the police officials because you are using a drone camera to take a shot of the entire arts college. But if it is an electronic news gathering, there is no need of taking permission because an event is taking place or an accident has been occurred. And that if you are going to capture for your news channel, then there is no need of taking permission. But if it is a kind of documentary or a film making, etc., then you have to take permission from the concerned authorities to shoot for your film. Different weather conditions on the location also sometimes adds aesthetic value or aesthetic quality of a particular field production. EFP and ENG enables us to capture the real life settings in a particular location. Generally, a lot of cooperation is required if you want to shoot for the EFP, electronic field production. For example, if you are shooting on the road, the persons who are traveling on the road, etc., have to be very cooperative for your shoot. So the cooperation is required when you are shooting in the location. But if it is a ENG kind of news event, if you want to go and capture, then there is no need of taking the cooperation. As the story is unfolding or as the event is happening, you have to go and get your right kind of footage. When you compare with the studio production, field production is also a time consuming thing. because you have to go to the location and you have to shoot. Then there is also a problem with the lighting. Generally, on the studio floor, you already know different lights are placed at different places so that there is a white balance can be maintained correctly. But if it is a outdoor production, generally there will be a lighting problem. If you are shooting outdoors, sometimes you may get more lighting, or the sunlight, as you know, the natural source of light. The density of the light may be more, and sometimes the density of light may be less. So depending on the location, you have to adjust your lighting. And sometimes the audio problems also may be there, what you call ambience. Sometimes it may be having a lot of noise when you record the audio. So disadvantages of electronic field production is nothing but it is time consuming, and different weather conditions may disrupt the recording process, and sometimes you need to get you need to have a lot of cooperation from the persons who are there in the location. If it is ENG, there is no need. Whatever happens, you have to capture. But if it is a kind of planned event like a cricket match, etc., there is cooperation is required. Process of single camera production is divided into three stages. The first one is pre-production, second one is production, and third one is post-production. Pre-production is nothing but planning of your single camera production, and second one is production stage, where the actual shooting takes place, you record. The third one is a post-production stage, where you actually edit the production. Any television program, for example, if it is a documentary or a serial, whatever it may be, it is based on a kind of idea. Ideas can be picked up from reading a novel, maybe when you read a book, when you are looking at the real life situations, etc., when you are looking at the people, their own problems, etc., you may get different ideas. So based on the ideas, you may be going to produce a film. But if it is a ENG, electronic news gathering, which is using single camera, there is no need of getting the ideas. But as your beat is assigned, or something is happening somewhere, that you have to capture for the audience. So then mind map. So mind map is nothing but you are mentally planning for your production. So for example, if it is an interview between the two persons, where you have to deploy your cameras, where you have to fix your lighting, where you have to go and to whom you have to contact, and what kind of visuals you have to take for your final production, etc. So you are getting an idea. Mentally, you are making the production to happen in a way that it will not disturb the process of the production. Then scripting, generally it will include the visuals which are going to be captured, and also it includes the dialogue part. Everything is written on the paper. So based on the script, you are going to shoot your production. So after the scripting is done, a treatment is prepared. So treatment is nothing but the narration of the story. It narrates the story from the beginning to the end, how it happens, what happens in between, etc. So the whole thing is the script narration is being written in the treatment. So see any story which will have the beginning, middle, and end. Unless it is a news gathering, it will not be there. So all this narration is being written in the treatment. So based on the treatment, based on the script, a storyboard is being prepared in the next stage. Each scene is being portrayed or drawn on a paper so that the director will have a fair idea about what he has to shoot on the particular location, if it is a film. So the storyboard helps the director to compose the right kind of shots for the final production. Then budgeting. So budgeting, as I said, is nothing but money which involves in the production. So at different stages, of the production. For example, if it is a pre-production, you have to pay for the script writer, you have to pay for the director, you have to pay for the storyboard artist, and you also pay for the other production person who are involved, production assistant, manager, etc. All that is included in the pre-production budget, and after that, the production budget. When the shooting is taking place, the transport, food, equipment, lodging facilities, traveling, everything for that, we also need budget. In the post-production stage, a video editor, the director, producer, video editor, along with that, there are assistants. So all the persons are involved in the post-production stage, and they are editing the film, which means each stage of the production, you have budget. So for that budget, what you need for the producing the program, everything is written down. So based on your budget, you have to plan your production. Whether it is a single camera or whether you are using a multi-camera, but you have to have a budget. Based on your budget, you have to plan your shooting schedule. You have to plan. Maybe you have to require the persons who are going to be before the camera. So depending on your budget only, you have to hire the camera persons, you have to hire the equipment, you have to hire the talent, you have to hire the script writer, you have to hire the cinematographer. So whatever may be the total budget of the film, that is included. The budget for the pre-production, budget for the production, and budget for the post-production. Equipment, facilities. So before the actual shooting takes place, the requisition is made, and the camera or whatever the equipment which is needed for the production is deployed on the shooting day itself. So for procuring that equipment, a requisition is made by the director or the production manager, etc. Then a checklist is made. Based on that, the equipment is carried along with the production crew on the shooting spot. Procuring permits. If it is not a ENG thing, generally if you are using a single camera and producing a film, etc., if needed, you have to get permissions for the shooting. So after that, a shooting schedule is prepared. It will look like a timetable from where you are starting, when you are starting, when you are reaching the shooting location, and when you are having the break, what kind of shoot is taking place, and when you are packing up, and when there is going to be a next shoot, the next day or maybe day after tomorrow, etc. Everything is prepared in the shooting plan. So before this shooting plan is prepared, generally a recce is being done by the director, production manager, and there are production assistants who may also assist the director. So they go to the location where the shoot is going to take place, and based on the recce only, they will prepare the shooting schedule. After the shooting schedule is prepared, the production stage starts. So here, during the production stage, you have to manage your equipment. Then blocking the shooting plan. So based on the shooting schedule, you are blocking your shots. So the entire scene or a sequence is divided into different shots. Then rehearsals have been conducted by the director. So if you see, before the production starts, there is a auditioning done by the director. In the planning stage only, you also hiring the talent. So the talents, depending on their dates, you have to plan your shooting. And your auditioning is being taken place before the shooting begins. So audition is nothing but the performers or the talent will give their trial performance before the director. Then the director shortlists the persons who are going to act in a film. So based on that, again, a second trial performance is being conducted. So then the director is going to finalize the persons who are going to be there before the camera. So based on that, what happens here, rehearsals are conducted by the director before actually the recording takes place. Or then planning and execution of shots. in the shooting stage, the equipment is deployed in that particular location where the shooting is taking place. And here, the director is composing the shot, execution of the shots. A scene may be divided into different shots, and different shot is composed by the director. So, based on the directions of the director, the camera person composes the shot for the final production. Then handling a master shot. So master shot is nothing but which establishes a situation. So the complete scene, whatever you want to record, is being shot in the master shot from the beginning to the end. So then the master shot is divided into different shots. Depending on the final requirement, the different shots are arranged in the sequence. So master shot is nothing but a complete shot of a particular scene where the talent is acting and simultaneously it is being recorded by the camera person, and that can be accommodated in the final stage of a production. It can be used. Then the shots are reviewed after the production is completed on a particular day. Generally, the director will see the footage which they have recorded on the particular day of a same action can be repeated n number of times till the director gets the right kind of visuals or the shot for his final film or final production. But if it is a ENG, electronic news gathering, using a single camera, as the story is happening, event is happening, you have to just capture whatever is happening there. In the planning stage, you are planning everything before the shooting takes place, and in the shooting stage, you are just going to the spot and recording your event. Then after that, the post-production stage begins. If it is a single camera production, so all those shots what you have recorded using a single camera have to be arranged in a sequence. So there are maybe lot of different tapes you have used for shooting different scenes, etc. Based on that, a log sheet is prepared. So the log sheet contains all the shots on the tape. It will also have the description and the duration of each shot. Based on the log sheet, with the help of the video editor, the director is going to edit the film. Then the actual editing. The actual voice may not be so clear on the location. So all the dialogues are again recorded in the recording studio where the dubbing artist or maybe the talent, the actual talent or the person may give their own voice for the dialogues. Then that is being lip synchronized with the original visuals which we recorded on the shooting location. Then after that, you may add the music or sound effects, whatever is required for the particular film. You may also use visual transitions. You also add the voiceover if there is any need. If it is a documentary using a single camera, then a voiceover is being mixed with the original visuals, and the voiceover will narrate the story so that the viewer get an idea of what is happening in the visual. So post-production is nothing but the editing stage. If you are shooting a single camera, generally the editing takes place at different point of time where you are arranging your shots in a sequence or in an order so that you can have a complete sequence of a film or a television program. In between shots, you are adding videos transition, and along with that, you also have the audio part. If there are dialogues, the dialogues are lip synchronized with the visuals. Along with that, music also can be added to the original video footage. And that is finally going to be there for the audience. So final sequence along with the visuals, the audio, the sound effects, visual effects, along with that music, all these things are finally exported to a form, whatever may be the means of transmission. So So this is the process of single camera production.